couples planning to kill recording and taking photographs at concerts, Metallica lands a hot new modeling career, and it's time for Slipknot to let Joey Jordison back into the band. You're watching The Smart Metal Show.
Give me a hell yeah!
I'm your host, The Elitist, your foremost expert on all things metal. So sit back and get smart, because you're watching The Smart Metal Show. Thanks for tuning in to another edition of The Smart Metal Show. I'm your host, The Elitist. Apple was recently granted a brand new patent that will allow them to prevent you from taking photographs or videos at any show who will install an infrared reader device. Of course, Apple always has the best interests of musicians in mind, so they're planning on taking on the most critical issue facing musicians today. No, not the dramatic decrease of music sales, mostly caused by the rapid uptick of streaming music services, particularly Apple Music itself. No, my friends, Apple is taking on the plaguing issue of cell phones at concerts. With a new infrared device installed right in the concert venue, Apple can limit iPhone users' ability to take out their phone and take a picture or a video. Of course, the venue owner or the band could also allow the fans to take a photo, with the option of the band or the venue adding a giant watermark to it. Metallica has launched a hot new fashion campaign with an Italian designer, and of course, I'm here to break down the photos for you with my expert analysis. Here goes nothing. Lars looks like the robber from Home Alone. James Hetfield looks like he's the one who forced the rest of the band to do it. Kirk Hammett looks like he just figured out that he needs to start practicing playing guitar a little more. He's gotten really sloppy lately. And last but definitely least, the bassist, Rob Trujillo, looks like somebody just told him that he's getting replaced by a backing track. And now it's time for the breakdown. Recently, former Slipknot drummer Joey Jordison has been making the rounds, talking about how badly he wants to rejoin Slipknot again. As you may recall, he was kicked out of the band in late 2013 and replaced by the son of Conan O'Brien's old drummer, Max Weinberg. What a real step up. Since Joey Jordison has talked about wanting to join the band very publicly, the one thing that Corey Taylor won't open his big ass mouth about is letting his former friend back in the band. Of course, it should come as no surprise to anyone that these days Slipknot seems to run away from any talent that wants to surround their band. Joey Jordison was the only member who was ever an expert at the instrument he played, and now Slipknot wants nothing to do with him. You heard the man himself. He went through a troubling, debilitating disease and has gone through years of therapy to get himself back on his feet, and Corey Taylor won't even offer him a place back in the band that he helped found himself. In fact, Joey Jordison said that he was fired from the band by an email and called it cowardly, and even then, Corey Taylor has nothing to say. But if you ask Corey Taylor what he thinks about politics, vaping, other dumb shit we don't care about, he always has an opinion, unless his opinion requires him to take a hardline, unpopular stance. What the fuck, Corey? Almost all Slipknot fans want him to return, and for good reason. He's one of the most recognizable figures in the band's history, not to mention the most talented. And he seems like he has genuinely overcome the overwhelming health problems that he was facing. It sounds and feels like a feel-good story, but for some reason, Corey Taylor isn't ready to extend that olive branch. I guess he just doesn't care what the maggots think anymore. And that's our show. Thank you to all of the smart metal fans out there who continuously tune in, who seem to truly get it. Leave a thumbs up on this video and make sure you subscribe for future Metal Sucks content, including interviews, music, and more news. And my friends, always make sure you remember to stay metal.